What's going on, YouTube? It's Don Jizzle, aka Fifth Scale RC Insanity, back again with another video update. So I just wanted to address some things. A couple of people have been leaving me messages. First off, I'm not doing any running videos because this is my winter build. People talk about they want to see this thing run and stuff like that. Well, I'm still building it, so it ain't nothing to see run. It's a winter build. I do a couple test runs and stuff like that, but you're not going to see any runs in the process of me building it. You know what I mean? I got to get it together first. All right, so that being said, I do got a couple updates. First off, I wanted to talk about, like, you see this back here? You see this this drive? I don't know if you can see it. It's a little loose in there. The reason why I put this bearing I got in here is like a rubber bearing. I think I'm about to change that rubber bearing out. See this, I gotta change that rubber bearing out, and I was gonna see how it ran with the rubber bearing, but I'll probably put a steel bearing in here. I'm gonna be taking this apart anyway because I'm gonna be changing this. I'm probably gonna put an aluminum a chrome shock tower or aluminum colored, silver colored shock tower with a shock brace, and I'm gonna be getting putting the C-hubs on here and the lower arms. And I'm going to be putting aluminum braces in here. So I'm just waiting for that to come in. I'll be changing that out. I ordered the front aluminum diff. So that's coming. You know, it's coming from Hong Kong. Same, it's the ice racing one, the front of this rear. So that's coming in. I'm gonna try the aluminum A-arms up front. I'm gonna put the aluminum A-arms. I didn't order them yet, but I will be. And I'll be putting the aluminum colored shock tower up here. And I'll be changing this gearbox out and changing the gas tank out to aluminum also, and the bumper. And I need to buy some C-hubs for the front. Actually, over here, I kind of changed my shop around. And I've been working on my car. Anyway, these are the pins. This is I did buy this. Remember I was telling you I ordered the gas, the boat one. Well, it was too small, and I just kind of broke it apart to get the pieces I needed out of there. It was like $8. So, anyway, these are the pins that go inside of this Turtle Racing get up here. So the pin goes in here, like so. But this one is actually too small. But I kind of heated the other ones up and straightened them out, so now I got two. I got them inside the house. Anyway, so I had to order. I had took the guts out of here, the bearings out of here. Got two bearings that go in here in the middle, and I kind of broke them out. And I ordered a whole bag of them. 10 of them or whatever. They're a specific size. So I got to wait for those to come in to start rebuilding this. So what I found out was when I had this flywheel. Is it this one? The flywheel. Hold on a second. Oh, here it is, yeah. This flywheel's cracked. That was the problem. I guess all the force, you see right there, the flywheel cracked right there from all the starting or whatever. I don't know. So I took out this chunk. Yeah, I'm gonna get another flywheel on this red cap motor, this Hung Yang or whatever. I took out this flywheel and put it on the on this engine right here. I put that in there. So we'll it works because I've been messing with these I've been rebuilding these pull starts and stuff, these regular pull starts, but they, I don't know, they just keep failing on me. I can't get them this crawl to grip or to stay, or it's just the plastic one snap. So I kind of modified these, and I don't know, it's just an issue right now. Just one of them things when you're doing the fifth scales. Here's that, I got some gas lines. They actually sent me some skinny, I guess this is nitro. This brighter color one is, that's good. This is the gas line. This is the sleeve that goes over it, the metal sleeve, I guess. Covered gas line. I was wondering what that was. So yeah, I got the diffs coming in. So these C hubs, the kingpins. So I met when I, you know, it's trial and error. Trying to get these kingpins out here. These are kingpins that go on top here. In the top, just nylon or whatever. Anyway, what these holes were, with these grub screws right here, they hold the kingpin. So when they were in the plastic ones, I banged them out. So in the course of banging them out, I kind of mangled them up a little bit. So I'm gonna be ordering some more C hubs anyway, and the ones I've seen come with kingpins, and I'll just be changing this whole mechanism out here. So turtle racing pull starts all the way apart, and I'm still waiting for some wrap to come in so I can I can reinforce this thing in the back here and make it stronger before I wrap it, and I'm still working on that and waiting on that to come in. I've been working on my real car, changing the headers out and getting some pipes in there and shit like that. So but as far as this is concerned, I'm gonna get the so the next things I'm gonna be putting on this will be, I'm gonna get the A arms, the front A arms. I'm waiting on this piece right here to come in, these aluminums. I'm gonna be changing all those out. I'm gonna be changing this steering brace right here to like a, to one with the bearings, like a Team Chase or whatever, aluminum. I'm probably gonna be changing, I'm gonna be changing this front brace to aluminum, and probably this top brace, this body brace, and this back brace. I'm probably gonna change to aluminum, and I'm probably gonna change this. Get a Bartolone one of these and change it to aluminum. To a chrome color. And I'm still waiting on the cracking to that won't be into March. So I still got some time with that. And that's pretty much it for now. Can't think of anything else that I'm going to be changing. Oh yeah. I'll be changing the front braces also to aluminum. So when all this comes in, it should be all, it's coming from us on a slow boat from China. So It should all get here around the same time. I want to say about March. I don't know. You know, who knows how long? Because as soon as they don't have them on deck. They when you order them, then they make them. They CNC make them. So I had, you know, I had good result with this as far as everything meshed up. It went in without a prop, without a hitch. Nothing was ill aligned. Before I ordered these front A arms, I wanted from that GPM company, I want to see what the back A arms look like. And that way, you know, I can see if it's a good quality, if everything syncs up. Not, you know, I'm not ordering them from there. So, once again, a recap. I'll probably be, you know, in the motor. Me and Boda Gel, we're supposed to go 50-50. You know, we're thinking about getting the same motor, so we're kind of waiting on OBR to see what they're doing, and then we're gonna try to both get our motors from OBR Racing. I will be buying another pipe for this to go on the Vecta 5, because this is a losi pipe or a King Motor pipe, X2 pipe. So I need another pipe to go on to match the Kraken. Yeah, so I'm gonna have to get another battery too. I'm gonna get another like a LiPo or whatever. So I'll be changing this whole body out, this whole brace out. And I want to get some aluminum arms here from somewhere. I don't know who sells them. I haven't been looking, but I want to change these out to aluminum also. Also, probably one last thing, I want to get some better diff cups for the back and the front, some hardened steel ones. Yeah, I want to change those diff cups out. Not that these are worn yet, but in the middle ones. I don't know if you can see this. Anyway, I can tell that they start to dig in on the back ones, you know, like the turn in here is starting to divot because the metal's not that strong. So, especially with a stronger engine, you're gonna need, I'm trying to reinforce this whole drivetrain. So I'll be changing out these cups here to try to bulletproof this whole drivetrain here. So, metal bumper, I'm gonna get that bumper, chrome that out. A arms, after I see what these rear ones look like, I'm gonna get these probably some hostile rear C hubs. Probably put some extenders on here. Aluminum diff braces. Aluminum towers with the tower holder. Front towers. Change these braces out, Bartolone. Change these braces out to chrome or silver, whatever. Bartolone to silver. Steering brace to a team chase, ones with the bearings. Front A arms with the back A arms are good. Got the Ice Racing front diff housing coming in, and I'll be getting the Hot Racing metal diff itself to go in the housing. And that's all I can think of right now, in the aluminum gas tank. So that's where I'm at with this for now. And then that should button this up, and then I get the wrap, whatever wrap I'm gonna get for that. That should button this up for now. But only in the controller, one of the Futaba controllers, a better radio. Our transmitter. That will button this up, and that'll be done with this project, this spring build, and I mean winter build, and then for the spring build, I'll be doing the Vecta 5 for the winter build. I mean the spring build. And oh yeah, and I'm gonna change the location. One of those aluminum carburetor air filters. Change the one with the silver one to change that out. So we'll see. One step at a time. It's all trial and error. Like I said, it's custom build. The shit don't just snap on. Ready to go. You gotta. Oh, and I had to rebuild my transmission here again, because I did start this before the pull. One of them cheap pull starts. It started up, and then when it kicked into second gear, it was slamming in the second gear, because dumbass me, trial and error, had put the one way bearing in backwards, so that bitch was slamming in second gear like it wanted to rip this whole thing off. If it was plastic, I think it would have. I only let it change gear twice. I let it change the first time and slammed in the gear. Thought it was trying to work itself out, and then it slammed in the gear the second time. Knew it was a problem. Took it apart, rebuilt it, fixed it. Now I need to test it. I need to do a test on it to see if that was actually the problem. But I'm pretty sure that was the problem. Trial and error, you know what I mean? It's like I'm not... I don't know everything. This is my hobby. So I just, you know, I practice and try to make these videos so y'all don't have to go through the same struggles that I go through. So I hope you enjoy them. Like, subscribe, do what you gotta do. I don't know. You know, I'm just into the fifth scale shit. You know what I'm saying? Fifth scale RC insanity. To all you insaniacs out there. So, you know, it is what it is. But we're going to keep it going. And I hope that you're enjoying the videos. Hope you're learning something from them. Hope you don't have to go through the same bullshit I'm going through. But, it's knuckle busting. But this is what it is. This is, use your mind. Expand your mind. Instead of being out there in them streets. You know, fucking up. You do a little hobby and try to be productive. Maybe you can help somebody. Anyway, that's neither here nor there. You want to go on the street and fuck up? Go on the street and fuck up, nigga. You know? I'm bugging. Anyway, it's early in the morning. I got shit to do. Got school, work, and whatever else. So, I was thinking about also painting this whole... roll cage here. I don't know what color to paint it yet, but I'm thinking about painting this whole roll cage also. I gotta take all that zip tie shit out of there, and a lot of work to do if I want to paint that bitch. Anyway, that's the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Shouts out to all the new subscribers. I appreciate y'all. Like, comment, let me know what you think. Any suggestions, let a brother know. And I'm out to the next video for shizzle, my nizzle, dizzle.